Hello and welcome to this session on creating a Selenium Java framework from scratch. And in today's session, we are going to learn about how to find web elements. So throughout your career, whenever you are working with Selenium, this will be very useful. You will always have to find web elements and locators and use them in Selenium functions. So let us learn that today. And as always, we will go very basic step by step. And all the notes and references and links will be available in the description section of this video. So let's get started. And step number one is, whenever we are working with any web application, we always have to first inspect the web elements that we want to work with. So let me take an example. Let us go to Google and let us go to the Google homepage. Okay, so let us say I want to work with this application, which is google.com, and I want to enter something in this text box. So the very first thing is I will inspect this text box and find out the locators. Now I'm on Chrome browser, so I can do a right click, and you can do this on other browsers as well and go to inspect. So as soon as you will go to inspect, you will have this developer mode where you can see the DOM and you can see the area that pertains to or that corresponds to this particular text box in the entire DOM of the web page is highlighted here. And here if you just zoom, you can see you have different attributes for this text box. For example, it is an input type and this is the class. Then we have ID, then we have max length, then we have name of this text box and so on. So these are some of the attributes of this text box, and using these attributes or using these locators or these properties, you can identify or locate this particular element. Now there are some tools as well. So if you go to your Chrome and go to apps and go to web store, here you can search for some tools. One of the tools is Esri. So this you can add. Then we have other tools like CrowPath. Again, you can add this. So I will just show you. For example, now once you add Esri, you will find it here. And here it gives you locators for XPath and CSS selectors. And again, if you do a right click and go to inspect, now you can also see once you do a right click and go to inspect, you are getting this pointer here. So you can take this and take this to any locators on your web page or any web element, and it will highlight it here. Now if you go to CrowPath, now once you add this CrowPath plugin, you will add it, you will find it here. And here again you can get all the XPath and CSS selectors. So if you say relative XPath and search for a node, it will give you the relative XPath, the absolute XPath. Now the difference in relative absolute XPath is, if you say absolute XPath, you can see it starts from the starting of the page and goes one by one down until that particular element. And if you select relative XPath, you can get that as well. Okay, so like this you will identify some locators or inspect it. And then step two will be, you can check any of these locators, which can be ID, name, CSS selectors, XPath, class name, link text, partial link text or tag name. Now let me show you why I am telling you this. If we go to our project that we have been creating earlier, here you can see. So let me just uncomment the part where we are setting property for Chrome driver and we are initializing a Chrome driver. And here we were going to seleniumhq.org. So what you can do is, if you say driver dot find element, so you will see there are here two functions of Selenium, find element and find elements. So find element will give you a single element and find elements can give you a list of elements. Okay, and here if you say find element, I am using the first one, and here if you say by, now this is again a class in Selenium, and say dot, now here you can see you are getting all these selectors or all these locators by which you can identify the elements. It's class name, CSS selector, ID, link text, name, partial link text, XPath and so on. So that was what I was telling you here. You can have all these locators to identify your elements. Now let us take an example. I will go to google.com. So here I will say driver.get, and instead of selenium.org, I am going to google.com. And now I will find the element of the this particular text box. I have to find it out, right? So let us say the ID here is, this is the ID, okay, lst hash ib. So I will say here by ID, and I have to give the ID here, which is lst, it's in small, lst hash ib. okay, let me just verify. Yes, it is lst hash ib. okay, and here now this will find the element. Now you can always store this in a web element type of variable. So if you say find element, you can say web element text box equals this. Okay, so I am finding this element and storing in the variable text box, which is of type web element, right? And now I can do any operation on this text box. I can say text box dot, I can click on this, I can send the keys. So you can see all these functions, click, find elements, clear, equals. I want to write something, so I will say text box dot send keys. Okay, send keys is again a function here of Selenium, send keys, and I can send anything here. I will just say automation step by step. Okay, now this you can do directly here as well. For example, I could have used this here directly. Let me just show you. I will copy this again and paste it here, and I could have set driver.findElement by ID this, and then dot send keys, and whatever I want to send it here, right? ABCD. So I can do in a single line, or I can first store it in a text box or any variable. So this is something you can have any name here, and then I am using that name and then having the operation send keys here. Okay, and let us try to run this. So I will do a right click, run as Java application. So it opens a Chrome browser, and yes, goes to google.com and types automation step by step, and then closes it. Okay, and let us also try this one where we have written in a single line. Here it should type ABCD. So I will save and run it again. Okay, so this should be commented out, and save and run this. So it goes to Chrome browser, goes to google.com and types ABCD, and it will now close it. Okay, so this is how you can identify the elements. Now also what you can do is you can create your own XPath as well. So most of the times you will be having some XPaths here instead of IDs or name. So here you can create your XPath. So for example, now I will say double forward slash, and if I say input here and hit enter, you can see it is finding 12 matching nodes. Okay, so there are 12 nodes or elements in this browser which are of the type input. And then I can say I want a input type where ID equals to lst hash ib, and enter. And here it did not find anything. Let me just see whether it finds with name attributes. I will say name equals q. Oh, sorry, I think I will have to use at here. And yes, yeah, that was a mistake. So you can create some XPaths like this, at name equals q, because you can see the name here is q, and now ID should also work. I will say ID equals lst hash ib, and yes, you can see it is finding one element and it is highlighting it here as well. So if I use this, I can use the same thing here instead of ID, I will say XPath dot XPath, and the XPath expression will be this one, input at, let me use name this time, equals Q. Okay, and here now let me try to run this again and see if XPath is also working. I will do a right click and run as Java application. Yes, XPath is also working and it will now close it. So we have seen XPath and IDs, and similarly you can use any of these locators. And let me also just show you, XPath is actually a query to search for an element in the XML document. So if you see this document, which is the source code of a web page, it is actually an XML document. So if I say sample XML file, let me just search for a sample XML file and show you. So I'm just going to this W3 schools and let me see some sample XML. Or let me say sample XPath here. Yeah, this is a good example. Let me go here, sample XPath. So you can see this is an kind of an XML document. So if I just copy this document and I will say XPath generator, I'll just search for an online XPath generator. So let me just see this one. Yes, so here it is saying insert your XML and then place the cursor where you want to generate the XPath. So yes, it is here. I will just copy and paste my XPath here, and here you can see I can click on any of this nodes or values. So suppose I click on this name, which is James, which is under the author tag, and I click here, you can see it is giving me the XPath. So I can identify this particular value using this XPath, which is a kind of a sentence or query that will pass through this XML document and get the location of that particular element that we are looking for. So similarly we use in web browsers as well, and similarly we use in Selenium. Okay, now we have done the second step, and the third step is also we have done partially. We have used find elements and also look at find elements. So until now we have used find elements. So if I select find elements, so I can say here driver dot find elements. So this time I'm going to select find elements. And again, it uses the similar locators. I will say by dot, let me say XPath. And here I am saying input, and that's it. So I'm finding all the elements that have, that are of the type input, and I can store it in a list. So if you hover over this, you can see this is of the type list web element. I will say list web element, and I can give any name, list of input elements equals this. Okay, and let me give a semicolon at the end. Okay, so I am taking all the elements from the page google.com that are of the type input, and I am storing it in a variable list of input. And now I can take the count. So because this is a list, I can use the function. I can say list of input elements dot size. So size will give me the count. Okay, and here I can also store it into any variable, or I can just this should be of type integer. So I will say int count equals to. Now do not worry in case you are not able to get all of this properly. In case you are new to Java and you are not able to get all of this, do not worry. I'm just showing you for understanding, and we will discuss more in the coming sessions. So I have just taken this the size of this list of input elements and stored it into count, and I can now print it on the console. So I will say SYSO, press control spacebar on my keyboard, and it will give me this option. So it will auto complete this statement, and here I can say count of input elements is equal to, and I will say plus count, which is this variable, and I can just comment this out or let it be as it is, and let us run this. I will say run as Java application, and it will open the browser and this, and what we are interested in is in looking at the console and see count of input elements is 11. Okay, so these are the very basics, and if you have the basics correct, it will be very useful when you go to high level of Selenium concepts. So we have done this and some useful tips. So whenever you work with your browsers or elements, you can check your locators on multiple browsers so that you are sure that your selected locators will work on all the browsers that you intend to work with. And you can also take help of these tools that we saw, like CrowPath, and then we saw Escree. These tools you can take help of, and then you can also create your custom locators or XPaths. And if your application is under development, you can always ask the developers to provide unique IDs to every web element, which will be easy for identification. So whenever you ask your development team, they can always give unique IDs to every web element, and that will be very useful during automation. So that was all, and let us do a very quick recap. Today we learned how to find web elements and how to use Selenium functions to locate elements, and I hope this was very useful for you. If you like this session, please hit the like button and share with others, and also hit the subscribe button, and don't forget to hit the bell icon so that you can receive all notifications whenever I will create new videos on automation, testing, DevOps and CI. I hope this all was very useful. Thank you for watching.